Well, New Hampshire Governor John Lynch wants to help close the budget gap by raising cigarette taxes. But local businesses worry that if the legislature votes to raise taxes on cigarettes again, they will lose a lot of out-of-state business. Here's News Channel 5's Jackie Bender.
They hit it twice last July. You know, the state hit it once and the federal hit it once.
Cigarette sales at the Beverage King in West Lebanon, New Hampshire, have dropped since the last tax hike in July. Now the governor has proposed a 20-cent additional tax on cigarettes to help close the state's budget gap, which is projected at $220 million in the next 2 years.
They're taxing the same old thing over and over again, which I think in the long run they're going to hurt themselves.
Walter Dow is an 80-year-old smoker and feels like senior citizens are bearing the brunt of this burden.
You know, to keep raising the taxes and taking advantage of us. And older people smoke more than the younger people.
I think they're discriminating against smokers. I don't think it's a good idea.
George Ashline thinks that an increased tax isn't enough incentive for a smoker to quit.
It's a hard thing to do. They're addicts.
But it may be enough for customers to take their business elsewhere.
Probably 50% of our cigarette business is out of state. Vermont, you know, Massachusetts, Connecticut when they're up visiting family.
But as the gap between cigarette prices in New Hampshire versus other states decreases, Hull fears so will business. In West Lebanon, New Hampshire, Jackie Bender, News Channel 5.